نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: وقال ربكم ادعوني أستجب لكم إن الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي سيدخلون جهنم داخرين. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, today the topic of this Friday's sermon is about supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is that we resort to Allah, pray to Allah, the Almighty, the Creator, and the one who nurtures and sustains us. We need to run to Him from time to time, from minute to minute, all the time. We have no other, any other thing to replace for us. So now, we have no choice but to beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to nag Him day and night so that He can give us relief, He can give us of His bounties, He can give us feelings and anything that we need in our life and in our life in this world and our life hereafter. So today, inshallah, the topic of dua, making dua, I want to highlight that topic. But inshallah, in any other, in the next, the following Friday sermons, I will try to go into detail. Today, I want to talk about it generally. And inshallah, I would like that every one of us, as we hear it today, then we have to put it into application. Apply it, then after that, it works for you. And have good faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Ghafir, verse number 60, Allah says, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أَدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. And your Lord is saying to you, or He is saying to you, and you have to say yourself, and your Lord, your Lord says to you, invoke me and ask me anything that you want, anything. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أَدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. So, ask me, then I will respond to you. And I'm saying to you, always ask me, and I will respond to you. Then we have to keep that Allah is responding to our invocation, our request, our begging, our supplications. All we need to keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. Allah continues and says, verily, those who scorn my worship, they will surely enter hellfire in humiliation. So if you are not asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not making dua, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, by the time you start asking Allah, then you are attracting the wrath and anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are always in two ways. Either you receive the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or you receive the anger. And the key of that is dua. If you are asking Allah, Allah is giving you His mercy. But if you are not asking him, that means you are so proud, you are arrogant, and you feel that you don't need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you are those Allah is saying, إِنَّمْ عَيْنَ يَسْتَخْبُرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُرُونَ جَهَنَّمَ الدَّاخِرِينَ. And indeed, those who are arrogant, and not those who are arrogant, and so scorn my worshipping, then they will enter the hellfire in the form of that they are under humiliation in the worst situation. In order to avoid that, then all we need is that we, first we do, basically, you know, you must be a Muslim in good faith and then asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you. But then, there are many things that falls into those, that discussion that we need to pick each one of them to pick at one point of it. First of all, we have to know that whether you are Muslim or not, whether you are in the best scholar or not, whether you are the highest spiritual leader or not, still you need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this case, we need to bear in mind this one. The one who is the highest, you believe is very high in spirituality, very spiritual person. And the non-believer, the atheist, are saying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes to begging Allah. So the worst person, the one who's atheist, don't even believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even insulting Allah, that one, if he begs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will respond to him. And the one who is the highest sheikh, the best scholar, the most knowledgeable one, if he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will respond to him. So they are equal in the face of Allah when it comes to begging Allah, in that bond and supplication. But then, there are some other conditions also which comes under the believers. The non-believers, they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah loves them and gives them His mercy. Where is the evidence? The evidence, the first and foremost we have as for to prove that, is just the beginning, our first father, Adam, and the first sinner, Iblis. So the first two, Adam and Satan, Iblis, they sinned. They are the first sinners. Both of them asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah gave them what they want. When Adam, when he ate the only tree which was prohibited from him, Allah said to him, eat from this garden, relevant. Unlimited, the way you want, but except one particular tree. But he ate from that tree. Then he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying to him, both Adam and Eve, they said, فَلَحَبَّنَا إِلَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنْفُسَنَا وَإِلَّمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Oh Lord, we became oppressors to ourselves. They became zalimin to themselves. So they said, we wrong to ourselves, but if you do not forgive us, we will be among those who are in loss. So forgive us. They asked him forgiveness, and Allah forgave them, and then that is one request. The other one, Iblis, the worst ever created. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to Allah, قَالَ رَبِّ فَأُنذِرْنِي إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. When Allah said to him, أُخْرِجْ إِنَّكَ مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ, Allah says, get out of my paradise, and you are among those who were cursed and cast away. Get out here. Then he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, said to him, قَالَ رَبِّ أَوْ فَانْبِرْنِي إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. Let me remain alive until the day of the doomsday, the last day. So he requested that, and Allah accepted that. When he begged Allah, his supplication, Allah accepted, and he is still alive. From there, you understand that the atheists, the worst evil, they have a life. And sometimes, they don't believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they may ask, they say, oh, I'm asking this, the superpower, the highest superpower, which is mysterious somehow, and Allah gives them. And in hadith, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned is, as it was reported, Allah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the example of the woman who committed a sin or crime and then repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just like one who was on a journey. He traveled where his food or his property were on him. And then he slept under the shadow of a tree. He took a nap, and when he got up, he looked around at the camel is not there anymore. He lost his camel. Then say the best car you had, with all your property, your language, your money, everything was there. So he was in a shock. He didn't know where to find, what to do, and immediately the camel came right in front of him. So he becomes extremely happy. It is like that way, because you were in loss, you ran away from Allah, you are in the worst situation, and you are coming to Allah, that in that situation Allah, you are approaching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with humility, with that of you confess your crime, and that Allah accepts your belief. And when you beseech Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, extremely nagging, Allah, oh Allah, need this, give me, forgive me, do this for me, and then Allah feels mercy and gives you his mercy. Then, that is the message we need to know, the dua. And then, how to beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's another question. How to beg Allah? It's just like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned to us in Surah Al-Baqarah, and this ayah, Allah is saying, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إلى دعاني فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. Allah is saying, and when slaves ask you, or Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they ask you concerning me, then you reply to them saying that let them know that I am indeed near to them. And then near, very close to them, which where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, Allah min habli al-wurid, that he is closer than to us, even our temples here. So he's in us and close to us. Then tell them that I respond to them. I respond to their invocations, the invocations of their supplication, or the invocation of the supplicant. I respond to them. When he calls me. So when Allah is saying, when he calls me. And so let them know that they should obey me and believe in me so that they may love right. They may go into the right way. Allah here is telling us certain conditions that we should understand deeply if we look at the ayah, where he is saying, if they ask you about me or concerning me, then tell them that I am very close to them. So, in that case, you don't need to shout when you are begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To scream badly, Allah is saying, وَلَا تَجْهَرْ بِصَلَاتِكَ وَلَا تُخَافِتْ مِنْهَا وَابْتَغِ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ. Do not scream loudly when you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not talk like that you are, nobody can hear you. You can't even hear yourself. وابتغ بين ذلك. Let it be in between that. So in a normal voice, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you ask Allah in that normal voice, that because He is very close to you, then after that Allah is saying, فَإِنَّ قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي. I respond to the bearing the da'wah, the invocation of the supplicant. So Allah did not say here, I respond to all the means, all the things that is in their mind. But when he asked me, I respond to him and give him that. Provided there are other conditions that I don't have time to mention there. But when they ask that, Allah is saying, إِذَا دَعَانِ. That is if they ask me, or when they ask me, what can you feel from there? You can feel there that there are many people who are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are asking for something, but through somebody, through something. So they are not asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. Then Allah is saying, you do not even ask me. You ask somebody else, say he or prophet, or from prophet to star. If you ask them, then they will give you. It's very clear. So your dua should be sincere and pure to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is dua? Dua is, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, it is a dua huwa al-ibadah. Supplication is the worship. So the worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we are praying, all we say, absurd, alhamdulillah, rabbil alamin, it's all supplication. So you are begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then, they are interchangeable, worshiping Allah and begging Allah. Then you have to understand. That's authentic hadith, sahih. Another hadith, which somehow it is not or some kind of weakness, but it's very important. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was reported to say that he said, Ad-du'a mufal ibadah. Du'a is the brain of the worship. So it doesn't give you, it's not giving you a different meaning, but almost the same meaning, because the brain is the backbone, is the first to the backbone of everything. Some people may think that the brain is only for thinking. No, brain, you cannot keep standing this way without your brain. The brain holds you and controls your actions, your words, and everything. So a human being begins from the brain, and the brain is the one that controls. Therefore, ibadah is controlled by the dua, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In all that, then we should know that we need that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always is there for us to accept our prayer and to listen to us, and always that He will respond to us. Either it is right away or later on, then we have to expect that. But in conditions that first of all, when you are begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you must have a good faith in Allah, and again, you must believe in that. First of all, you have to recognize your fault, your faults, your mistake. You have to admit and recognize, and then after that, you tell to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah, I committed this sin, forgive me. And what to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that needs another day of sermon. It is too large. But then first of all, you have to admit, as Adam admitted, say, رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا ذَلَمْنَا أَنْفُسَنَا وَإِنَّمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And then after that, you must be free of doubt. You should not be in doubt of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to you. You must believe in that. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أُدْعُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّكُمْ تَرَوْنَ. So you always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a clear vision that you're sure you will get it. And you have to initiate first asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should not expect someone else to pray on behalf of you. So you start it with pure heart and sincerity, and then always make sure that you are very close to Allah and nobody is making whoever comes in between you and Allah. Whoever you are, no matter who you are, nobody is in between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the two other things that you have to avoid haram, the prohibitions. And the first, only example I can give this is that it's what that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in Hadith of Qudsi, that he gave us an example of someone who is in a travel. He's a traveler, he's on his way, a long journey, and he is in this situation, he's very tired and full of dust, and he's walking barefooted like that. But he's in that situation and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He raises his hands up and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So like that person, he is in need of response. But Allah is saying in the Hadith al-Qudsi, da'amu haram, wa sharabu haram, wa malbasu haram, wa ghudiyu haram. So his food, the food is in his stomach is haram. The drinks that he had is haram. And the clothes he's wearing is haram. And his nourishment that he grew up with, haram. So he was fed with haram from the very beginning, from long time he was eating haram, and his body is already full of haram. فَأَنَّا يُسْتِجَابُ لَهُ. How? And Allah is saying, how can I answer to that person? How can I respond to such kind of person who's full of haram? So first of all, we need to purify ourselves. And if we are in a mistake, then of course we are always in mistakes and sins, then we have to admit and recognize and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. So even that person who is in all that situation, he still has the chance, because in that hadith, Allah will not say, I will not accept his supplication. But Allah is saying, how can I accept his supplication in this situation? So that means he should go back and purify himself, make himself clean, then he will get all kinds of help. He will get the bounce of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mercy of Allah. And in all that, today, our situation, brothers and sisters, is that we worry about the food we are taking. We say, oh, we have to go to halal meat and get the meat from the halal meat only, where there's only stamp. But we don't worry about the money we are buying for it. The money we have, going to the shop or to the butcher and buying the meat, is that money haram or halal? That is the one we should first think about. Not to worry about what somebody else did, how they slaughtered and how it happened. That's something which is not in your hand. First of all, worry about the money you are using to buy for the food. Before you worry about the food, and you worry about being cheated by somebody else. Then, because haram is not something that somebody can give it to you in the wrong way, it is the fault of that person who gave it to you, not yours. Only you control yourself, because you have the authority to control yourself. And my point is that dua is the local ibadah, it is the ibadah of itself. Worshipping and dua are equal. My dear brothers and sisters, I just conclude that, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who maintain begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all the time have the remembrance in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and invocation of Allah, begging and nagging to get the branches of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah guide us to the right path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divert us from the wrong path and lead us to the right path in order to save us from the hellfire. أوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل وأحذركم بنفسي ونفسكم بمخالفة الله وإحسانه وأقم الصلاة.